If you are interested how to turn a reef tank with a blooming field of cyanobacteria back into a pristine reef, then stay tuned and check out the 5 tips that helped me along the way over the years to remove cyano, and maybe there's also something in for you there as well. My tip number 5 is leveling the nutrients, the nitrates and the phosphates in a ratio from 100 to 1. So that means if I would have a target range of 10 parts per million for the nitrates, I would want to have 0.1 parts per million for phosphate. The way I do that usually is obviously, first of all, I have to measure it to get a very clear understanding which value is in my tank. And for this, you need a very precise measurement tool, like for example, the HANAD checkers, where you have a digital reading. It usually, if you take test strips or something like this, it's probably just not accurate enough. I don't really have a lot of experience there, but I would say it's probably not accurate enough to really make a consideration to adding certain nutrients into your tank. But what I do and often use is the Brightwell Neo Nitro. So that one I use to bump up my nitrate in case I have low nitrates. And if I would have low phosphate, which is usually not the case, but it happened before, then I have a product from Emmy Coral. It's a company, I think they are somewhere in Florida. It's a highly concentrated solution. So on that one, you just have to dose a couple drops. On that one, you have to dose definitely more. So it's a little bit less risky to overdose with that one. But for me, it's kind of a great thing to just make sure nitrates and phosphates are in a perfect level. And I have the experience that then also you usually don't really have a lot of nuisance algae and bacteria craziness going on in your tank. So tip number 4 is siphon out the cyano with a hose during a water change. So if you make a water change on your system and you see little patches of cyano, especially in the substrate, in the sand, then just go ahead and just kind of suck the patch out. Even if you have a little bit sand that comes out as well, don't worry about the sand. You can always put the sand back in. It's just important that these big, chunky, red patches of cyano get sucked out. Because oftentimes it's not only the red thing you see visually on top, it's also the cyano goes a little bit in the sand. So if you take the tiniest little bit of substrate with, that's actually a good thing, and it helped me always out in the last couple times I did that. My tip number 3 is something I do often, not only because of the cyano, but sometimes also because my tank's always bringing substrate sand to the corals. I go inside with an aquarium pump or a power head, and then I just move along the rockwork and just blow it off. You can also usually, if it's cyano, you can very easily blow that off. It goes then into the water itself, so make sure you have proper filtration. In my case, I have a filter roller and a skimmer. So that's kind of mechanical filtration that takes it then out of the water. And I also have a UV sterilizer that additionally helps then removing the bacteria or kind of destroying the bacteria in the water for removing the cyano. What I also sometimes use is a turkey baster. If you don't have a spare pump, you can use a turkey baster and just kind of blow it off that way off the rock. It's a really, I think that's more kind of if it's not so critical and urgent, the situation in your tank. If you just have tiny little bits and pieces, then you can just go ahead and blow it off and don't worry. And most of the time, it actually doesn't come back. If you have a healthy ecosystem in your tank with microorganisms. Tip number 2 is using Microbacter 7. So it's something that helps with the establishment of a bioculture of kind of microorganisms in your tank. And I'm not an ultra chemist or something like this, but I used it over the years a couple of times. And I'm not sure if I had success because I used it or if it's just kind of almost a little bit a piece of a snake oil or something like this. But if you go through the forums and also people from my Instagram page, a lot of people recommend Microbacter 7. Some people in addition with coral snow, so that's a kind of a calcium carbonate additive, they mix that together There's a page which I can link in the description below, which shows a little bit how you mix the coral snow together with the Microbacter 7. And apparently the coral snow helps then with the Microbacter 7 to kind of cover the surface of the substrate and as well as of the rocks. And apparently with that combination, the cyanobacteria cannot take a hold of. And that probably also helps a little bit with battling these nasty little cyanobacteria patches we have in our reef tanks. And now my tip number one, it's actually really, if you have a very drastic situation, it's usually the only thing that really solves the issue, at least. I had it once in the past. I used a similar product. Back then I used ChemiClean. This time I used the red slime remover because that's apparently a little bit less potent, so you don't, it doesn't go as harsh on your tank, but I didn't even have really issues with ChemiClean. That one is a solution. It usually comes in a little package like this. It's just powder. You have to mix it with water. It clearly tells you how much you should use. That one says you should use one kind of scoop of spoon with 15 gallons of water. You put it then inside, and within usually only 24 hours to 72 hours, it clears up everything in your tank. In my tank, from the picture you saw, it actually really just took not even 24 hours before it kind of almost completely removed everything. I see here and there still a tiny little pieces of red, so there's probably still a little bit left, so maybe I repeat them. The procedure, but for now I'm just leaving it. What's very important to know when you use the ChemiClean or the red slime remover is your skimmer will completely most likely overflow because it creates much more foam in your skimmer. So you could switch it off and just kind of leave it like this. Some people say like you should put in some air stones into your tank. I have quite a lot of flow inside, so I'm usually not too concerned about my tank, but if you don't have a lot of water flow, maybe definitely add the air stones if you switch off your skimmer. Or what I do with the skimmer, I just raise it up maybe 2 or 3 inches, and so then the water level is like way under normal operation the skimmer has usually the water level. But it still makes the skimmate and it still aerates the water and everything. So I just usually do it like this. I just lift up the skimmer 3 inches and let it run for a couple of weeks till it kind of settles down. And then I can also clean the skimmer and just kind of put it back down. But this is really the only thing that really actually helped in my case. So it's my top actually recommendation if you battle with cyano. Sometimes I feel I waited way too long to even start using these products. I get it. We all want to make it slow because it's actually a very good recommendation to go very slow in the reef tank. But sometimes just kind of things go out of control. And if you then have for weeks, I was reading from people, they were battling cyano, completely cyano coverage in their tank for almost half a year to a year. And I think that's just not worth it to kind of put yourself and the corals and everything under so much stress. So maybe consider something like this, red slime remover or ChemiClean, but just make sure you read very good the description because nobody wants that you kind of harm your corals or your fish in your tank. Or if you have any kind of questions, feel free to reach out in the comments, or you can ask anybody else in the YouTube world where they have coral videos. I'm sure they can help you out. So it's good to ask and investigate before and then do the thing rather than the other way around. But these are my top 5 tips. I hope there was something that you could learn as well. And if you have some questions, concerns, or any other things you would like to add, put it in the comments and then we all know something more. But that's it for now. Check maybe also out my monthly updates. So I always give a monthly update about the reef tank. So you see then if all the cyano battling was successful in my tank, or maybe it came back, or who knows what happened next. Check it out, subscribe, like to the channel, and I see you next time.